Write on the question.
The edge length of a FCC unit cell is 508 picometer. Edge length of a FCC unit cell is 508 picometer. The radius of cation is 110 picometer. Find the radius of anion. Edge length is 508 FCC unit cell. Radius of cation is 110 picometer. What is the radius of anion? Done. What is the answer? FCC unit cell, right? So in FCC unit cell, how the atoms are arranged? Ions. Along the phase diagonal, we have anions present, right? And cations are present here. See this diagram. Anions, and here we have cations, right? So what we can write? This distance is what? 2 into R plus plus R minus is equals to A. A is given 508. So 508 by 2 is what? R plus R minus is 2. 54. So R minus is what? 254 minus 110. Right, option A. Next question you write down. Just you need to know the position of ions. An ionic solid A plus B minus, crystallizes as an FCC structure. The ions along the phase diagonal. Has been removed. What is the formula of the lattice? AB FCC unit cell, atoms along the phase diagonal. So phase diagonal, all anions we have to remove. Phase diagonal, B, A plus and B minus we have, okay? So B minus, A plus and B minus if you see. Right? And we know anions occupy CCP arrangement. Right? Like NaCl. Cl minus occupy CCP arrangement. B minus present at corners plus phase center. Okay, so when all the atoms along the phase diagonal has been removed, it means we have 2B at the corner and one phase center B. 3B we are removing. 2 from the corner, 1 from the phase center. So 6 corner atom left, 6 into 1 by 8 and 5 into 1 by 2. That is B. So this will be what? 26 by 8. It is 13 by 4. B. A is what? A occupies octahedral void. That won't change. A is 4. A 4. B 13 by 4. A 16. B 13. Correct? Okay. Now see, we have an FCC unit cell. Okay. AB atoms are arranged in this. Now all atoms along a diode has been removed. All atoms along a diode has been removed. What is the formula of the unit cell? Diode is two-fold axis of symmetry. It is a line which passes through the crystal, okay? And when you rotate the crystal along this line, the same appearance appears twice. That is a diode. Okay. See, last class I have discussed on axis of symmetry. In this we have discussed three things. Two-fold, three-fold, and four-fold axis of symmetry. Two-fold axis of symmetry is a line which passes through the center of the cube. Right? And when you rotate the crystal along this line, as I rotate here, the same appearance appears twice in one complete rotation. Okay? So this line is a two-fold axis of symmetry. Isko ek baar rotate karoge, so 180 pe same appearance milega. Phir se rotate kiya, again 180 pe same appearance milega. So same appearance appears twice in one complete rotation. That's why this line is a diode. Okay? So the question is, the atoms along this line has been removed. All atoms. Okay? So what is the formula of the number? A plus B minus.
A
10
by
4
B 4 B 4 A 5 B
A 5 yeah
A 5 B 8. See, along this line, what are atoms we are removing? We are removing one edge center atom, okay, one body center atom, and again one edge center atom, okay. And edge center page, we have octahedral void. So cations present in the octahedral void. So we have A present here. Yahan pe bhi A hai. Because body center mein bhi octahedral void hoga. Aur yahan pe bhi octahedral void. So 3A we are removing actually. Okay. 3A we are removing. 2 at the edge center and 1 from the body center. So number of A is what? We have 10 edges. 10 into 1 by 4. और बॉडी सेंटर में तो है नहीं, सो ये हो जाएगा 5 by 2, क्या हो जाएगा, B हो जाएगा 4, सो A 5 by 2, B, A 5, B, 8, is the answer, okay, now if the question is atoms along 4 fold axis of symmetry has been removed, 4 fold axis of symmetry has been removed. Four-fold axis क्या होगा? Opposite face centers, opposite face center, हाँ, and center, body center plus opposite face center.
So
AB. Okay. Done. Yes. So along this line, two face center and one body center. Okay. So B is at the face center and corner. So corner we have 8 into 1 by 8 and face center we have 4 left, 4 into 1 by 2. So 1 plus 2, 3. A is what? A is 12 into 1 by 4 because body center is removed, so plus 0. So it is 3. So answer is AB. Done? AB. The last one, when we remove the atoms from 3-fold axis of symmetry, this line. Three-fold axis of symmetry.
Two
corners
and
body center. Only? Alright. We have tetrahedral void also here, but atoms are not present there. That does not make any difference.
So
you can
A 19 B12.
I don't know. Is it A19 B12? Huh? Done. See, along this line, we are removing two corner atoms and one body center. Corner atom B is present. B is what? B is 6 into 1 by 8 plus 6 into half. So it is 3 plus 24 plus 6, 30 by 8. So it is 15 by 4, right? A is 12 into 1 by 4. So it is 3. A 3, B 15 by 4. Right, so A 12, B 15, correct? A 4, B 5. Okay, so you must know the this line is 3-fold axis of symmetry, this is 4-fold, and this is 2-fold axis of symmetry. Okay, one more thing you must take care of. Along this 3-fold axis of symmetry, we have two tetrahedral voids also present. Okay, so if any atoms or ion present in the tetrahedral void, that also you have to remove. Okay, in this question it is not there, that's why. Okay, next write down magnetic properties. Write down every substance has some magnetic properties associated with it. Every substance has some magnetic properties associated with it. Electron itself behaves as a small magnet. On the basis of magnetic properties, the compounds are classified into following categories. The first one, paramagnetic. This is because of unpaired electron weakly attracted towards the magnetic field. Examples of paramagnetic compounds are O2, VO, CuO, TiO. All these are paramagnetic substances. Okay? Diamagnetic. All electrons are paired. Weakly repelled by the magnetic field. Examples are benzene, KCl, NaCl, etc. The third one is ferromagnetic substance. Ferromagnetic substance. These are the solids which are strongly attracted. By external magnetic field, and they do not lose their magnetism. Definition based question they ask on this. And they do not lose their magnetism when the external field is removed. Examples, iron, nickel, FeNi, CrO2. CrO2 we use in audio video tapes, okay, because it is permanent effect, so audio video tape we use this. Next item is write down, it arises due to the spontaneous alignment of magnetic moments. Due to unpaired electron, in the same direction. Next slide. The unpaired electrons of one atom. The unpaired electrons of one atom interacts strongly with the unpaired electron of the other atom, and they align themselves, unpaired electrons align themselves in a very small region called domain. Okay, in same direction. Small region in same direction called domain. Means all the electrons, unpaired electrons, are aligned in the same direction. Okay, this way will be always all the electrons in a very small region called domain. Okay, so this is ferromagnetic substance. The important thing here is that they does not lose their magnetism when external magnetic field is removed. Okay, that is the difference. Fourth one, ferromagnetism. Next, right on fourth one. Fourth one is anti-ferromagnetic solids. Anti-ferromagnetic solids. Write down the solids which are expected to show paramagnetism or ferromagnetism. Paramagnetism or ferromagnetism. On the basis of the unpaired electron present. On the basis of the unpaired electron present. But actually they have zero net magnetic moment. Are called anti-ferromagnetic substance. Anti-ferromagnetic substance. MnO2, Cr2O3, etc. Why they are anti-ferromagnetic substance? Because electrons are aligned in opposite direction, like this. Here all electrons are aligned in the same direction, but here we have alternate. One is upward, other one is downward. So these two cancel out the magnetic moment of each other, right? That's why they have net zero magnetic moment. Okay, this is anti-ferromagnetic substance. So paramagnetism and ferromagnetic substance are those which is attracted towards the magnetic field. They have unpaired electron present. Here also we have unpaired electron, but they align in such a way that they cancel out the magnetic moment of each other, and hence they have zero magnetic moment. Net magnetic moment is zero. Okay, examples are this MnO, MnO2, Cr2O3, etc. Next one, write down ferromagnetic solids. These are the solids which are expected to show very large magnetism due to presence of unpaired electrons, but they have a smaller value of net magnetic moment. This is due to the random alignment of electron. Examples, write down Mg2O4, Fe3O4, etc. Random alignment of electron. So there's no order arrangement here. Suppose one is up, one is down, then again two electrons on this side. Random arrangement of electrons. Okay, so suppose these two cancel out the magnetic moment, these two cancels out magnetic moment. Okay, and if you have some more arrangement like this, these two cancels out, right? but these two electrons and this electron gives a red magnetic moment. Like we have unpaired electron present in this. So we have unpaired electron, but random arrangement gives a smaller value of net magnetic moment. Here we have maximum magnetic moment, and here we have zero magnetic moment. Okay? Example Fe3O4, Mg2O4 are the examples we have here. Okay? Now in this, there is a term, we call it as effect of temperature. Effect of temperature. This alignment of electron you must remember here in these three compounds. Okay, what kind of alignment we have. Okay? Write down effect of temperature. All ferromagnetic, antiferromagnetic, and ferrimagnetic substance. All ferromagnetic, ferrimagnetic, and antiferromagnetic substance has property to become, has property to show paramagnetic behavior on heating. On heating. Okay, the next line. The temperature at which these solids behaves as paramagnetic solids are called Curie temperature, C-U-R-I-E, Curie temperature. Okay, so for iron, the Curie temperature is 1033. For nickel, it is 650 Kelvin. For Fe3O4, 850 Kelvin. Okay, Fe3O4, this question they have asked once. At what temperature this behaves as a paramagnetic solid? Okay, Curie temperature is 850 Kelvin for Fe3O. Okay, this temperature you must remember. Definition only important over here. All these magnetic solids.